Whatever we create in this video will be available for free as a template. All you have to do is be patient and actually watch the video. So let's create a social media pop-up for live streamers and YouTubers, I guess. As long as you use a broadcasting software such as OBS Studio, Streamlabs OBS, Twitch Studio, Polypop, a TikTok Live Studio, you will be able to use it. And this video is sponsored by Good Vibes. Anyways, I hope you're ready because this is about to go pretty fast. Step one, go to photopea.com or Photopea as I like to call it. Let's open up a new project. When it comes to the width, we're going to put like basically 1080p because that's what you're used to. You know that your monitor is 1080p. If it's not, put whatever resolution your monitor is. So 1920 by 1080. When it comes to the DPI, we're going to put 300. So it's high quality. And then we're going to click create. Now, why do we do this? Social media pop-up is not going to be 1080p. It's because we can have an idea of how big we want it to be. We're going to go ahead and click on the crop tool or press C on our keyboard. And then we're basically going to click and drag how big we really want it to be, right? Once you do that, press enter. And there you go. Now you can press Control Plus to zoom in, just not too much. Let's go back to the move tool and we're gonna start creating our social media pop-up. Now, Photopea is completely free. You just get ads on the side. I'm gonna select my background. I'm gonna press Control I. And if that doesn't, well, it does work, never mind. We're gonna go and find the shape tool here, rectangle. If it doesn't say a rectangle, you can click and hold and then pick whatever shape you want. But we're going to start basically drawing rectangles. Before I start drawing rectangles, I'm going to go up there on the options for the shape tool. And I'm going to pick white as my color, right? So it's really visible. First of all, we know that we're going to have a space for the text, right? So I'm just going to make a rectangle. Wow, you're a professional graphic designer. You can make rectangles. Now I know that I also want a space for the logo of the social media that I want to display. So let's go to parametric shape. And in this case, let's go with six sides. I'm going to hold shift to keep it proportional. I'm going to press space and hold that in order to place it. Lift your finger from space and keep holding shift until you find something that you like. I'm going to overlap it a bit and then drop. Okay, cool. We are not done. I'm going to select the first shape tool because I want whatever I'm creating to be on top of that. Or you can just rename this blah, blah, blah. Okay. Press enter. Okay. That's good. Then I'll select this one and I'm going to go ahead and create another rectangle. Oops. Actually, that's not a rectangle. You can press Control Z to go back, click, hold rectangle. Now you can create a rectangle. Nice. Let's create a rectangle here. You know what? Let's create more rectangles here, here, and here. Why not put a rectangle there? I think a rectangle there would be cool. Let's put another rectangle right over there. Nice. Let's put a tiny rectangle here and a tiny rectangle there. I am very proud of you. You're putting rectangles everywhere. You are literally, literally a graphic designer now. Congrats. One more rectangle right there. Nice. Now, I'm going to go ahead and click on my zzzz, okay? And then I'm going to click on effects and we're going to start adding some effects. First effect we're going to add is bevel and emboss. It's going to make it look a little 3D-ish. And for the, basically for the size, we're going to drop that a little bit. About 2, soften, make sure it's 0. And technique, we want this to be chisel hard. Depth, we want that all the way up. And we want opacity and screen to be like this. Like that, basically around 50%. Cool. We also want a little bit of shadow. So we're going to click on drop shadow and check that. Nice. We're going to angle that way. And we're going to bring the distance in a lot. Maybe the size down a little bit also. Cool. Opacity also down about 20%. Cool. Click OK. Nice. And now our goal is to basically duplicate this effect on everything else. Okay. So I'm going to click on that little arrow. And then I'm going to hover over effects, hold alt on my keyboard. That's like you hold alt, you click drag, and that's how you duplicate stuff. Click drag while holding alt the whole time. Drag. And I'm just dragging on top of it. Hold alt and just do that for all of them. Nice. You can collapse them if it's too much. Isn't that beautiful? All right. Now I'm going to select all of them. I'm going to pick the one up top, hold shift. Select the bottom one, it will pick all of them. And then I'm gonna go up here. If I'm still on my shape tool settings, I'm gonna go and find something like a dark gray. It's like my favorite color to do graphic design in. Dark gray-ish, I think that is pretty nice. Okay, cool. Now I know that my bottom one here is gonna be, well, it's selected, basically it's showing you. And then you see the rest and all of that. And from there, I can change the colors, right? I want this to be a lighter gray. I'm gonna click here and I want this to be, oop, there it is. A lighter-ish gray. For the rest, I can also play around with them or just modify all of them at once. like that. For our shape here, I want to duplicate it. I'm going to hold Alt, click on the layer, drag up, boom, I duplicated it. I'm going to press Control Alt T in order to transform it. I'm going to hold Alt on my keyboard and I'm going to drag down like so. Nice. Okay, cool. And then I'm going to change the color to a darker background. All right, let's do the magic thing. Let's select every shape except the two top ones. Press Control Alt T. And in here, you're going to hold Control. You're going to hold Control on your keyboard and click on that top bar here. And then you're going to make it diagonal-ish. You can do it on this side. You can do it on that side. It doesn't really matter. Actually, this side looks pretty cool. There's as much as you want or as little as you want. I don't care. It's yours. Then press Enter. Nice. Pretty nice. Now go click on the T or press T on your keyboard to bring up the type tool. And we're going to go ahead and find a font that is, of course, pretty sharp. All right, I found one called Iceland. We're going to click on that, and then we're going to click somewhere here, and I'm going to put just whatever social media. In my case, let's start with Twitter. And right now we don't see it because it's underneath every layer. I'm going to click here. I'm going to drag it all the way to the top. Nice. This is what it looks like. And then we need our character options. We can go to Window, click on Character, and it will show up here. From there, you can choose the color. Nice. We're going to go with white, the size. You can click on the word size and make it bigger. You can also make it full caps like this. Click on the move tool or press V on your keyboard to move it around. I think this is pretty nice. Actually, let's go a little smaller. And then we have paragraph here. Same thing. If you don't see this, just click Windows paragraph and we're going to center it. That way, if I replace it, it'll be centered. Nice. Now let's add an additional text just to type the name of the social platform up there. So in here, I'm going to click on the T, click once on the canvas, and I'm going to type Twitter. All right. I'm going to make sure I select all of this, and then I'm going to go back to my character, drag it down. And in this case, I want the tracking to be a little more nice. So more space in between the letters. And in this case, I want the paragraph to be aligned on the left. Cool. And while we're at it, we're probably going to add some color. So I'm going to go ahead and already give that Twitter-ish colors. Nice. Click away or click on the background, for example. Pretty cool. Now all we need is the Twitter logo. Now you can download those from Google. You just need to find transparent ones. Of course, as a graphic designer, I have a folder with a bunch of logos. I can just drag and drop. So once you download, that's all you have to do. Let's bring this towards the middle. Remember, you don't see it because it's behind everything. Put it under the text. Actually, I'm going to keep it. Control Alt T to transform, remember, and then click a corner, drag in, put this like that. There you go. I want maybe more color, more of that blue. So I'm going to add a glow to that shape right behind it. And it's this one. Nope, it's that one. Cool. Remember the effects? Nice. You can double click on effects to bring the whole panel. And then you will find outer glow. Outer glow. You can click on it to mess around with the options. And let's go with that kind of blue, of course. Or you can just color pick the Twitter logo. All right. We want the size to be much more. We want the blending mode to be linear dodge, and we actually want to reduce the opacity a little bit. Maybe bump up the spread. That works for me. And just like that, you made your first one. Congratulations. We can play around with the colors a little bit more. I double click on the icon here. Maybe I want that background one to be a little darker. Nice. So now I'm going to group everything so that I can duplicate it and then create the same thing, but for another platform, right? So I'm going to select everything and I'm going to press Control G. If you want to see what it looks like on the background, this is what it looks like. Okay. Now I have my first folder and that folder is Twitter. Cool. I'm going to hold Alt on my keyboard, drag up. That's how you duplicate. Turn off that first one and we're going to call this one YouTube. Nice. So that means I need to go in there. I need to delete the Twitter one by dragging it to the trash bin here. I need to double click on my Twitter text to type YouTube. I'm going to double click on it again. Just make sure I select it and I'm going to make it red, of course. Nice. I need to double click on the outer glow of that shape to make it also red. Cool. And now I just need a YouTube logo, which I have in my folder right here. So I'm going to drag, drop, and I'm going to align and basically place. I can hold Alt to drag from the middle, basically. And boom, just like that, I have the YouTube one. Nice. Let's continue. Hold Alt, duplicate. I'm going to do the same thing for the rest, basically. All right, once you created everything you need, for example, we have Instagram here, we have TikTok, we have Twitch, and then YouTube, and then Twitter. We're going to export them one by one. So Twitter, for example, I'm going to go to File, Export As, PNG, click Save, and find a sweet little folder to put it in. I'm going to name it Twitter, press OK, and boom, it downloaded it. In fact, there it is. Beautiful. Do the same thing for the rest. YouTube, File, Export As, PNG, Save, YouTube, Enter, and it's downloading. Twitch, same thing. Nice. Now we have all of them in one little folder. Let's open up whatever service we use for our browser source. In this case, I'm going to use Stream Elements. I'm going to log in with my Twitch account and I'm going to find my overlays. Streaming Tools, Overlays. And I'm going to create a new one. You don't have to create a new one. You can just add this to your existing overlays, but I'm going to create a new one. New overlay. Overlay resolution, we're going to keep it 1080p for now. And we're going to click on Add Widget. We're going to go to Static Custom, Asset Rotator Slideshow. Click on that. And then we're going to have a bunch of options to add assets. From there, we're going to add our assets. We're going to click on the plus here. We're going to go to Upload, which is over there. And we can drag and drop straight from our Windows Files Explorer right there. Drag, drop, wait. It added them. And from there, you can click Submit on the first one. That's the Twitter. Nice. Add asset. Submit on the second one. Add asset. Submit on the third one. Ainsi de suite. Now you want to read the options that you have. Delay is the time between each image. But here at the bottom, we'll see show images for, and basically that's how long you want each image to show up for. It's fading in and out right now, but we have animation settings. You can't see it because of my camera. But at the bottom, we have something that says animation settings. Click on that to pick your animation. So fade in, maybe not. What does zoom up looks like? I hate it. There's also the exit animation. And you have a duration for each animation. Here I have slide in up, and then I have zoom out down for the out animation. I'm gonna close this. Up top, I'm gonna name this pop-up. And I'm gonna click save, top right. Now, if you want it to disappear for a little bit, basically before it starts over again, you can do that here. Iteration pause is what you want to enter the value for. But I'm doing a tutorial. I don't want it to be invisible at any point. I'm gonna go up here and I'm gonna click copy overlay URL. Click on the link. And we're gonna use the beauty of OBS Studio to add it. Click on the plus to add a new source. Go to a browser, name it pop-up if you want to, or pop-up. Press enter. And basically you want to paste that link that you just copied. Control V. And here you can kind of decide what size you really want it to be, knowing that your Stream Elements canvas is 1080p, but it tells you right there that it's 340 by 340. So let's do exactly that. 340 by 340. And then click OK. It should appear somewhere. All right, you can see it up top here. I can drag it. I'm dragging it in OBS. You can even put it on your camera if you want to. But there it is. You did it. You created an asset rotator. You created a social media pop-up. And it is animated and you have full control over it. And then you can add new stuff. The thing that people ask me the most when I make those videos about the pop-ups is, oh, can you add a SoundCloud? Yes, you can. You can do everything. I literally taught you how to do it from scratch. You should know that all you have to do is basically go in here, hold Alt to duplicate, and then go find the logo of whatever you want. Delete the previous logo. Instagram, trash. Or you want to change the text, double click on the T and type whatever platform it is. You want MySpace? Let's go. MySpace. Oh, but how do I change the logo? Go on Google Images. Type MySpace logo. Go Google Images. Okay. And then find one with a transparent. You see how the background got transparent? Right click on it. Click copy image. Go back to Photopea. Press Control V. And you have it. It's right here. You just need to size it. Control Alt T. We went through this. This is the transform. Hold Alt to drag from the middle. Bring it back up. Hold Alt to drag it from the middle. There you go. Press enter when you're ready. Go back to the outer glow. Double click on it. Click on the image. Just click on the color you want. Boom. Boom. Okay. Okay. MySpace. Double click on it to select it. Click on the character thing to pick the color. And then click on the blue. And there you go. You just created your own custom one. And it's MySpace. And I'm going to delete it because I don't want to leave it in a template. This will be a template. And this is how you get to the template. You go to photopea.com. You're going to click on templates. Nice. And then you're going to type my name. Gael Level. Boom. And you'll find all of the stuff that I created that is also available for free. All you have to do, for example, this was the previous one, right? 7 months ago, I created this. You can just click on it and then you have it right there. You can start editing it. This one is a little more complex, but there it is. It'll be the same thing for that one that we just made. Click on the one you want, expand it, click on the text to modify it, put whatever you want. And there you have it. You should definitely follow me on all those socials. If you have any questions or just want to express your gratitude, leave the comment in the comment section below. And I will see you all next time. Thank you so much for watching. Go out there, make me proud, get a level, out.